Hello everyone, welcome to the last tutorial today. The topic is cross-validation. In a previous video, we showed that when there's flexibility in choosing the model complexity, for example, the polynomial order in the polynomial regression, a bad choice of the order would lead to either underfitting or overfitting. So we need to do model evaluation by splitting the data into a training set and a test set so as to select the best model with the smallest test error. However, in many cases, one random split could result in a biased training and test distribution. For example, here's a full data set. And then we do one random split, and we might get a split like this. The black dots are for training, and the yellow dots are for test. The green line is the true model, while the red line is the model fit using the training set. We can see the model fit doesn't match the model, the true model very well, so the model evaluation given such a split won't be very trustable. We want to get rid of such type of randomness induced by the splitting procedure. One solution would be doing multiple random splits and cross-validate the performance on different splits. This is what we usually call as cross-validation. Specifically, if we do the multiple random splits with k-folds, this is known as k-fold cross-validation. Here's what I mean by k-folds. We randomly split the data set into four folds. The number of data points is in each fold would be similar. Each color corresponds to one fold. Next, we construct four training and test splits. Each one uses one fold as the test set and other folds as the training set. For example, in the top left figure, fold 1 in the split is used for test, and all other three folds are combined together as the training set. Now take one split as an example. Remember to define a model to evaluate at step 0. Here, for example, we evaluate the linear regression model. Step 1, we take one fold as the test set and rest as the training. Step 2, we feed the linear regression model with the training set and get the optimal theta p. Step 3, we calculate the MSE on the test set by using this math equation with the above optimal theta p, where x test and y test denotes the test set, n test is the number of data points in the test set. Now we complete one procedure to obtain the MSE for fold 1, we could repeat the same steps to another split with fold 2 as the test set and repeat the same steps to all splits. Finally, we average the MSE across all folds and obtain an averaged MSE to represent the performance of this linear regression model. Remember, this is only a k-fold cross-validation for one model. In order to do model selection, we need to repeat the same four folds cross-validation on other modes with p is equal to 2, 3, 4. Notice that for each p, the folds we use are the same. Finally, we could plot averaged MSE for all polynomial orders and pick the best model with the smallest error. Another cross-validation solution is called leave one out cross-validation. Instead of leaving a fold out for test, we now leave only one data point out. So in k-fold, we have multiple points in the test sets, right? Basically, the more folds we split, the more precise the measure is, because weird splits such as the one I showed at the beginning of this video will be averaged out. But that is at the expense of greater computational cost. And leave one out is the extreme where you pick one data point for test, thus you have as many folds as data points, and that's usually the computational cost is very high. Okay, we then feed the model with the training split, test split, and calculate MSE on the test data point. And we repeat this for all data points and obtain an averaged MSE. The number of time we repeat is n because we have n data points, right? Finally, we repeat the same leave one out cross-validation on all polynomial orders and compare. The figure shows the average MSE for all polynomial orders using leaf-one-out cross-validation, which selects the same best model as k-fold cross-validation does. So in the following notebook, you will implement k-fold cross-validation for model selection of polynomial regression. I talk about leaf-one-out, but we don't expect you to do exercise on that in the tutorial session. Okay? Hope you all enjoy.